In the past, I've talked about painting with a soft, round brush, almost like an airbrush. And then since the paint is on its own layer, switching to the eraser tool, using a hard eraser, and carving out a sharp edge. And in this way, getting both a soft edge and a hard edge. And then as you continue, you'd make a new layer, lay down more paint, and erase, and continue this process. In today's video, I'm going to show you a slight variation on this theme and how it might apply to more technical edge control areas. But as a quick reminder, if you look below the post, you'll find links for free brushes and worksheets, as well as in-depth premium series available in the Ctrl+Paint store. Here you can see I've got a quick tracing of a skull. And the reason I didn't just draw this is because what I'm working on today is rendering. So I don't really want to waste time doing a careful line drawing if all I really want to practice is painting inside of it. So I've made this tracing, and I want to do some of the simple shadowing underneath. With my line work layer on top, you can see that's in red here, I'm going to be painting on all layers below the line work. So I'll make a new layer, select the brush tool, change to a hard round brush. So it looks just like this. It's got pressure sensitivity, but hard edge. And using that brush, I'll begin on the hard edge of the shadow. And right now, that happens to mean the edge of the form. And using this hard brush, it gives me nice control of that edge. It's a lot easier to get that exact shape if you're working with a hard brush than it is if you're working with a soft brush. And you notice I'm not being very careful about the other edge, which is going to be the soft edge of my shadow. And I'll show you what we do with that in a minute. Okay, so I've put in my hard edge using the hard brush. Now I'll switch to the eraser tool, select a soft round eraser, and then I'll erase away the soft edge of the shadow. This is where the paint is going to transition from the dark area into the light area. And obviously I'd be a bit more careful if this were a finished piece, but I'm just giving you guys a quick example. So in this way, I've started with a hard edge and then erased away the soft edge. So I get the best of both worlds. Now let's say I wanted to darken in maybe the eye cavity. For that, I'd make a new layer, select this color, make it a little darker, and go back to the hard round brush. So I paint it in place. Worrying more about the hard edge and less about the cleanliness of the soft edge. Then I select my eraser, go to a soft eraser, and erase away the excess and make that transition. So you can see why working on independent layers is important. Now, if I'm happy with the way those two layers work, I can flatten those together with layer, merge down. So now I have a single layer for my rendering information. But while I'm working on it, when I'm laying down the new paint, it's important to keep those separate. At this point, I'm going to finish out the skull, but as you can tell, I've sped up the footage quite a bit. This is one of those processes that does take a while. Like most things in art, you gotta have patience. But if you watch those first few examples, then you know how I'm doing every step along the way. It's just one process repeated over and over. So really, there's not much of a secret to it. Add some with the hard brush. Take away some with the soft brush. Very simple. You'll find really that the challenge begins looking at your subject, looking for where is a hard edge and where is a soft edge. It's those hard and soft transitions that interplay across the form that really create a believable surface. And so knowing how to lay down a hard edge and a soft edge comfortably with your paintbrush allows you to focus more on looking at the subject and recording what you see. So I encourage you guys to give this a try. And to help you out with that, I've actually included this drawing of a skull with the reference next to it as a downloadable image at the bottom of the post. So good luck with this and have fun practicing. Thanks for watching, guys.